Assalamu alaikum. Hello everybody. Today inshallah we're going to have a new video and we're going to teach you how to perform salah. Before we start this video today, I would highly, and I stress highly, recommend you to go and watch the last two episodes of the terminologies of salah and the terminologies of haram and halal, because most of today's videos are going to be discussed using some of those terminologies, and those terminologies are going to ease out the things for you. So if you watch it, this episode will be very, very easy for you. When you watch those last two videos discussing salah terminologies and halal haram terminologies, you're going to find that Muslims have five salah. Each salah has different number of rak'ah. Some have two rak'ahs, some have three, some have four rak'ahs. And what we're going to do today is a bit easy and different. We're not going to perform five different salah, of course, but we're going to perform one rak'ah, and you will repeat this rak'ah easily, and we will tell you the differences between rak'ahs if there are any differences at all, because differences are very few. That's why we realize that just knowing one rak'ah will allow you to do the other. Second thing, I'm very sorry for any environment background noise, as songs or music or whatever, because Masjid is in a highway and there are lots of noise surrounding this, so I cannot control this, so I'm sorry for that in advance. Also, I would like to tell you that I'm going to take videos of me performing this rak'ah from the back and from the front, so that you would see the shape of the body and the positions of every organ of your body. I will tell you what should be said in each movement of salah, and then you repeat this easily for other rak'ahs in salah. So one of these demonstrations is going to be four rak'ah salah, and the other one is going to be two rak'ah salah. Another rule I'd like you to learn about salah: whatever salah that has two or three or four rak'ahs, all of them has some fixed rules. Easily, try to listen carefully and you will understand how to make salah without any effort. One of these fixed rules that the first and the second rak'ah in any salah, whether it was two or three or four rak'ahs, has to have small surah next to Al-Fatiha. The other rak'ahs, the third if it's three rak'ah salah, or the third and the fourth if it's four rak'ah salah, you don't have to read this small surah. Any salah must end with tashahhud, and this tashahhud has to be complete if this is the last rak'ah of salah. This last rak'ah could be the second or the third or the fourth. Okay, what happens if salah is three rak'ahs? If salah is three rak'ahs, the second rak'ah will have half of the tashahhud, and the third will have complete tashahhud, then taslim. And if salah is four rak'ahs, the second will have half of tashahhud, and the fourth, which is the last one, will have the complete tashahhud, then taslim. This doesn't change. That's why today we're going to teach you what you should say in the fixed rak'ah. And this rak'ah could be easily repeated, and then you perform salah. When performing those rak'ahs, you will not hear takbir, because I needed you just to learn how to move. But we explained this before, that between each movement we have takbir, which is Allahu Akbar, and we said the reason why. The only time you don't have takbir in salah movement is after ruku'ah. You just say Sami'a Allahu liman hamida, and this is something also we showed in salah. And the time of taslim, where you say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, to end salah. So let's get talking and let's go to masjid. There are many things we need to clear out. Okay, in general, where do Muslims look while they are performing salah? You have two options. First one is to look in the place of your prostration, where your forehead touches the ground, like this. Looking down here.
in the place where you're going to make sujood. Or you can look ahead of you like this. Whatever brings khushu' to your heart, do it. No problem. Both are correct. Some people, they feel khushu' when they look there, and some people, they feel khushu' when they look ahead. Nothing is wrong. Okay. Second thing, is there other things that other people say in salah? Yes. But this is high level. If I mentioned that it would be hard for some new Muslims and it would make things a little bit harder to understand and harder to memorize. So I needed the accepted way of making salah, and after that you would learn step by step. We can make something advanced after this. Okay, if I make this beginner salah, is it going to be accepted? Inshallah Rabbil Alameen, it's enough for you. Okay, what about the other one? The other one gives you more hasanat. At the beginning, you have to concentrate on the rule that says first thing first. So you have to take what you don't know. After that, you learn step by step. Okay, as we mentioned before, we're not going to talk about the importance of salah or about the rules that governs the conditions of salah, what makes salah spoiled and what makes it correct, because that's for another time. Just we concentrated today on performing salah. You enter Salah with Takbir, and the Takbira, the one that you enter with, is called Takbira al-Ihram. It's the first Takbira in Salah, and you do like this. This is the way you do. Some people do it like this. This is not correct. This is not fard. It's Sunnah, Mustahab, to be like this. You will take Thawab when you do it like this. Allahu Akbar. You start like this. That's a good way. You take Thawab. Okay, what happens if you don't do it? Not haram, but you miss Thawab, which is good, by the way. You miss lots of hasanat. When you start Salah, as we saw in the demonstration, you stand like this. First, you should have done wudu. We talked about this before. Number two, Qibla should be towards you. Must. Number three, you must have intention in your heart that you are now between Allah's hand and you're going to make Salah or connection. And then you start like this. Allahu Akbar. You can put your hands here. You have many ways. You can hold your right on your left, or you can just put. But it must be right on left, not the opposite. This is wrong. Right on left, like this. Where to put it? Here, 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 as you like. No problem. Nothing There is no restriction here. So, like this. And then you start reading Al-Fatiha. There is something before Fatiha, it's called Dua Al-Istiftah, but this is not easy for beginner Muslims. So we'll start from Al-Fatiha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Malik Yawm al-Din. Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. You can say آمين or you cannot because it is not one ayah of Al-Fatiha. After you finish Al-Fatiha, you have to say, but this is not a must, it's optional, Sunnah, as we said before, small surah like بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. Okay, you finish now what you should say in Fatiha. Raise your hand like this and say Allahu Akbar. And make ruku'a. In ruku'a, you should look in the place of your sujood like this. Okay, how you make dua? You have to catch with your hands like this on your knees. Like this. Your back should be level as much as you can if you don't hurt yourself. Like this. Your legs shouldn't be like this. Or like this. You have to be middle. Like this. On the same level of your shoulder. Nice stretch. Nice open. Like this. And then you say, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. 3 times. Okay. After you go up from ruku'a, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ means Allah would hear whoever make hamd and thanking for him. That's the meaning of it. And then you say, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ. Some people from ruku'a, they do like this. Some people, they don't. Some people, they make like this. Some people, they leave their hand like this. All is correct after ruku'a. No problem. Then you make sujood by doing this. Allahu Akbar. So, when you make sujood, sujood is like this.
Your hands here, it's in the same level of your head or a little bit lower, like this. But not like this. This is wrong. Like this or like this. And here, there is a space here, as you can see. There is a space here, and a space here.
Your belly here cannot touch your thighs. You can't make like this.
That's wrong, okay? You cannot do
like this. What do you say in sujood? In sujood, you say, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. 3 times. And then you make whatever dua you want. When you sit here between sujood, okay, you put your hands like this. Some people put it forward, some people put it back, no problem. And in the middle of 2 sajdas, you can say, Rabbi ighfir li, which means, Allah, I ask you for forgiveness. Okay? The dua you want. When you make the shahud, in the shahud, which is as we saw, you have, if it's 2 rak'ah, you have 1 tashahud. It's more than this, you have 2 tashahud. The first tashahud, you say half of tashahud. What would you say in tashahud? You sit like this, put in your hand like this. Some people raise this finger like this from the beginning, and some only raise it when they make shahada. Okay, put it like this, and you say, At-tahiyyatu lillah, was-salawatu, wa-t-tayyibat, السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله. Look, this is my finger here. Till this, عبده ورسوله, this is the first half of the shahud. You say this in the second rak'ah if salah is more than two. If salah is three or four, so in the second rak'ah you have tashahud, you say half of tashahud. What happens if you have three rak'ah or four rak'ah and you have tashahud like this, and you need to say, you complete this tashahud after you say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله, you continue saying, اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد, وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Okay, you finish this. After finishing this tashahud and before making salam, you can pray, make dua with whatever you want. Ask Allah for anything you want, anything. There is no limit here. You have many dua. And inshallah, we could make a video for dua. If you needed this, leave me a comment. If you needed to make video for many dua, you can say whatever dua you want. After you finish that, you make salam. Salam like this. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. That's it. Now you finished salah.
I hope you liked what you saw, and I hope what you saw was useful. If you found this video useful, spread it, share it, and subscribe to my channel. Let other people know about Islam. Who knows, this could be your way to Jannah. Until I see you another time, take care of yourselves, and Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.